Breaking news, Jamal Adams is softer than every ice cream served at McDonald's, Friendly's, and Dairy Queen combined. Let's get started, baby. First things first, I got my fucking John Lennon shades on to keep out the haters. Cause you know there's gonna be a bunch of dumb Jet fans out there. They're talking, oh, we're gonna miss it. We ain't gonna miss shit. So without further ado, let's get into it. For those of you who don't know, Jamal Adams, aka Fake El Presidente, that El Presidente sits with Dave Portnoy, because at least he can run a fucking company. You couldn't even run a defense, buddy. Has left the New York Jets. Well, not officially, he hasn't left yet, but it's gonna happen. Because he demanded a trade. You know where he wants to go? He wants to go to America's team, the Dallas Cowboys. What? Bro, the Dallas Cowboys can't even get over the hump against the Eagles. All he had to do was go 500, and they make the playoffs. But no, they won 7 games, and the Eagles fucking went. Dumb Fox, there your argument's over. Jamal, you want to win? You're going to the wrong team, buddy. But let's focus on Jamal before we go to the other morons. Jamal Adams, you have the audacity to sit there for multiple years. I want to be a Jet for life. I'm in it for the long haul. I'm the captain. I'm El Presidente. I run the show. I will teach you guys how to win, and we'll win together. Newsflash, buddy, you're live. The second adversity had knocked on your door, you went packing. You got your suitcase, you got your Louis bag, and you hopped in your car and you drove away because you can't take the heat. You are scared of the truth. You never could have ran this team. You think you could direct the defense? You couldn't even direct traffic, buddy. So shut your mouth with this Presidente bullshit. Only Presidente is Dave Portnoy at Barstool Sports. That guy can't lose. You only can lose. Jamal, ever since you joined the team, we haven't had a winning season. And you want to call yourself the captain? Well, the captain is usually at fault. Thanks, sweetheart. You led us to under 500 3 years in a row, and I fucking clap for you. I clap. You suck. You are so bad. And you call yourself a president, a fucking leader, a captain. Oh, I'm sorry, a couple keyboard warriors decided to tweet and DM you on Instagram, and you just can't handle it. What kind of leader are you? Oh, because some people don't like you or calling you a diva, you start to go AWOL? Newsflash, buddy, you just fucking proved them right. You are a diva, because the second that people started talking bad about you, you went home to your mother, started crying, and wrapped yourself up in your 20-pound weighted blanket, you loser. We don't need you. We don't need you. You are a safety, champ. A safety. We need a cornerback. We need a defensive end. We got fucking Marcus May, buddy. Guy would start on any other team, but since we had you, he was playing half reps. Well, goodbye, Jamal. Marcus is half the price and a 10 times stronger fucking willed player. Maybe we should call him El Presidente. The president, captain, you freaking loser. Marcus May is half the money, and now we just drafted White Lightning Ashton Davis from UCal. What are you gonna do now, Jamal? You thought you had job security? Well, you don't. You don't, you got 2 more years on the contract and you're sitting in the corner crying that you want more money. Bro, you signed a deal. You signed it. Don't play, we don't pay you. If money's all you care about, then go get it somewhere else. Oh, but wait, apparently it's not. You gave us a list of 8 teams that you would go to without requiring a contract extension. So your big problem was us that we wouldn't pay you yet. Even though we told you wanted to be your Jet for life, we're gonna pay you, we're gonna give you a fucking haul, you're gonna be the highest paid safety of all time. No, that wasn't enough. That wasn't enough. The fan base was behind you, you gotta keep running your mouth. You were like a fucking printer just printing out bullshit all the time. And I hope you're happy. Cause now, not only does I hate you and the Jets hate you, New York hates you. You thought that the DMs and everything were bad before? Bro, I can't wait to look at them now. You drive around in Dallas in your nice G-Wagon and say, I'm out trying to get to Dallas. Yeah, bro, go there. I'll ship you there. I'll give you a fucking Starbucks gift card too while you're at it. Oh, wait, it's not like New York. You can't just walk around the corner and find one at any fucking second. Now you gotta go hunt for it. You win all the gunslinging desert in Dallas now. Have fun with that. Yeah, the weather's consistently 110 fucking Fahrenheit. So, yeah, that's fine. That's fine. You are a disgrace. You know who was the president of the Jets and will be for the next 15 years? Una momento. This
handsome fella right here.
Long Dick Donald.
Look at that. Boom.
Number 14 for the New York Jets, with luscious hair and even hotter face, Sam Darnold, our quarterback. A useful and needed position. Not like a safety. So you know what? I'm thankful. Cause this is the leader of the New York Jets. Not fake Presidente Jamal Adams. Sam Darnold, AKA Long Dick, AKA Sam the Savior, AKA better than you, Donald. You got nothing. We don't need you. Greg Williams is one of the best defensive minds in the league. Look what he did with a defense last year. That was without CJ Mosley and Avery Williamson. Now we don't need a QB spy like you. We got two more, Chief. So goodbye. Good riddance. Go fall in a hole for all I care. You are not worth the money. Give me two first round picks. Give me a first and a second. Hell, give me a fucking Big Mac with extra mac sauce. I don't care. Whatever it takes to get you the hell out of here. Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed this rant. I hope Jamal Adams sees this and I get a nice, kindly worded message from him, because he'll get one from me. If you liked the video, subscribe. If you didn't, I don't care. I'm clearly a Jet fan and I hate this guy. If you like him, then there's something wrong with you. I'm sorry. I would say your opinion matters, but most of the time they don't. Love to talk. Love to see you. Love to be you. See you next time.